What's up, girl gang? Welcome to the Inner Sanctum. I'm Yoda Guru. Come on in. Sit, stay, relax, put your feet up, grab a couple snacks, have yourself a cold beverage, your choice, your prerogative. My sanctum is your sanctum, and enjoy my reaction to episode number 5 of the continuation of Quantum Leap. This episode is titled Salvation or Bust, and apparently Ben has leaped into a an old-timer in the Old West. As we learned during the episodes leading up to this episode, that the restraints were removed, and Ben can now leap beyond his own lifetime. So who knows where he's going to end up. It could be far into the future, far into the past, who knows. During this episode, Ben leaps into a female bounty hunter and gets hit on instantly, much to the delight of Addison. And then we meet Jake, her bounty hunter partner, and apparently his soon-to-be fiance, because Jake, played by Justin Hartley, Arrow's Oliver Queen, he proposes, but he tries to hold off on saying yes. Ben does, by just saying, let me think about it, and that's a point of contention for Jake. So, during this episode, we find out that Magic is an individual that that Sam in the OG episode helped save along with the platoon, and not only that, Tom Beckett, Sam's brother. So Magic has a reason for wanting to bring back Sam. So that was a mind-blowing conversation with Ian in the park. So another Easter egg, a huge Easter egg to put a pin on, as Ian would say. In any case, I'm looking forward to reacting to Salvation or Bust, episode 5, now that we know that Ben finally remembers Addison. And that's going to be a really interesting dynamic right there, knowing that Ben now knows. And it took a while for Al to remember his wife when Al and Sam switched in the original series after that lightning strike. And so it's a different dynamic when it comes to in this early stages of the series, that Ben and now knows that Addison is the woman he loves and was going to marry. So let's not waste any time and get into the reaction part itself. Before we do, if you enjoyed any of my content, whether it be from my Inner Sanctum channel or YG Anime channel for all things anime, link is right up there. Check that out. Help support that channel as you're supporting this channel. Much appreciated. Thanks to you guys. Tip of the hat to you. And when it comes to the full-length reaction of this episode, I'll post it in my Patreon Rumble, all full-length, sync up on your end, like all the other past videos that have been posted in the past, and Patreon and Rumble. Those two links, along with my social media links, will be posted underneath this, in the description section underneath this video. And like I mentioned earlier, if you enjoyed either content for your channel, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe, hit that notification bell in order to be notified of any future videos being posted on either channel. And with that said, let's get into episode number 5 of the continuation of Quantum Leap. Title episode, Salvation or Bust. All right, here we go. Yep. Ben stepping to what is in fact the Old West. All right, Sheriff's Office, wanted posters.
We knew it would happen eventually.
Magic, I know you're worried about Ben's motivations, about why he leapt, about why he didn't say anything, and I know that you didn't want me to jog his memory because our only safeguard was that if he didn't remember anything, then he couldn't remember his agenda.
Things have changed since
yep.
then. Janice is in our system. Mm-hmm. She's stolen government hardware. This is a fluid, active situation we just don't understand yet. Ben trusts you. Now even more so since he remembers you. At this point, any insight he has into what is happening is information we sorely need. You don't have to hold back anymore.
Well, that's awesome.
Thank you.
That's a relief to her.
Thank you.
It has him.
Where is he?
That cannot be right. 1879?
Ladies and gentlemen of Salvation, I come before you on behalf of the estimable Board of Directors for the Southwest Pacific Railroad Company.
Railroad, all right.
To remind you that the deadline for you to accept their offering of a rather generous, life-changing compensation presently
paying
draws
them off
apace.
To leave.
Salvation had its heyday during the gold rush, but those days are
gone. Ooh, that's not
gone.
Good.
This here boom town's gone bust.
Well, good riddance, I say.
Should you choose to reject my employer's offer, they have empowered me and my posse here to see to your permanent relocation, at which point all that was once yours will become theirs.
Taken by force.
I'm to inform you that we have petitioned the governor against a railroad claim.
Oh! Threatening warning. Just shot the sheriff.
No one
probably
cares.
Shoot the deputy.
Which is to say, in summation,
citizens of Salvation, you know who I am. So you know what this town means to me. Which is why I'm asking you to ignore this sinvergüenza.
All right.
Remember my father's vision for this place. Salvation has already arrived.
Fire and feisty granddaughter.
And who, pray tell, is this savior come to deliver you?
The legendary gunslinger, mi abuelo, Diego de la Cruz.
Right.
I've heard of you, old timer. If you're the savior, these people are already damned.
Oh.
Look, no one here wants any further violence. Maybe, there's some other arrangement we can work out.
Only one way out, partner.
I want to help, I really do. It's just your abuelo isn't the man he used to be, especially not at this specific...
No te preocupes. I know just what you need.
What do you need? What does he need?
You are Diego de la Cruz, a famed Mexican-American gunslinger who hung up his six shooters and retired to San Francisco after your wife died.
Hmm.
Your son, Marco, was the mayor of this town, but he too died recently.
Which is why Valentina sent that letter asking for help.
You met the granddaughter.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Kid. She just promised
feisty and fiery, like I said.
An outlaw named McDonough.
Actually, he never fought. Looks like Diego and Valentina skipped town, so there was no showdown.
It's a relief. Was I, kind of feel like I hate guns. Does that line up with the Ben you knew?
Yeah. You're a pacifist.
Well, I mean, that's gonna cause
a
problem.
I can't be here to win a gunfight.
And records in this era were spotty at... best. And having a
really how you do that?
Database? Probably because we're so far back in time. Okay, I'm gonna go back and talk to the team, see what info they can rustle up, okay?
Okay.
I'm Frankie. It's a pleasure to finally make your acquaintance, senor. I was real close to your son.
How close?
His passing was a loss for us all. I've been looking after Valentina like she was my own. What's mine is yours. What can I tempt you with? It's on the house.
Oh, that's very... Thank you. Thank you. But I'm recently engaged.
She'd kill him.
Aren't you a little young to be in a place like this?
I'm 15.
Why stay? What? There are other towns.
Not like Salvation. This place was built by outsiders for outsiders. Women like me can't even get a bank loan, and look at me now. Sole proprietor of this here saloon. I busted my ass for all that I have. I'm not just gonna walk away from
it. She's like the Miss Kitty of the saloon.
It's not just me. And there's only one way to protect... Your son asked me to keep these safe. Your wife sent them to him before she died. Said she hoped they'd bring you two back together.
Six shooters.
Trust me, violence only begets more violence. Let me talk to the sheriff's deputies. I think I have an idea.
Hopefully it'll work.
We gotta pretend like we're not in the middle of a leap. Like, right now. Ben needs
why?
This information right now. He is in 1879.
Which is an unauthorized activity that we've been keeping secret. Something that maybe our friends in Congress who fund us probably shouldn't care about.
Why are you talking like that?
Why?
Oh.
Okay, so there's trouble in a
Congresswoman.
Congresswoman Kavita Adani.
Congresswoman.
She's a member of the project's oversight committee and a rising star in D.C.
Jen.
Dr. Song.
Uh-oh.
I'd love to get his expert scientific opinion on the status of things.
You want to see Ben now?
He's here, isn't he?
Not at the moment, no. Something came up, a personal matter. He's currently off site.
Until when?
Well, it wasn't exactly clear on that.
I'd love to have a chat with your team. Perhaps you could arrange to sit down with them, each of them, separately.
Uh-oh.
Now.
Okay.
After Diego skipped out on the showdown, McDonough drove the people out.
Yeah.
The railroad took over, and Salvation disappeared. I mean, practically was erased from the map. Dunna is a wanted man. There's a huge reward out for him and his gang.
Use that.
Maybe enough to pay off the railroad and save the town.
We're on the same page. I was on my way to talk to the deputies.
Those deputies?
Oh, they're leaving, I think.
They're not riding out to stop McDonough, are they?
Are they?
Afraid not, senor. They're quitting.
Oh.
Why?
Made them a better offer.
Ah, crap.
They're not coming back. So what's your
He forced them out.
I won't
bribed
take your
them.
Money. And I can't let you hurt these people.
Or paid them off, so.
I'm sure you dealt with some bad hombres in your past. She ain't never met one like me.
Definitely gonna be a showdown.
This is gonna end badly, isn't
Yeah, well, hopefully not for Ben.
Ziggy says there's an 87% chance you have to duel Josiah McDonough to save the town.
Ooh, that's not good. And he's a pacifist, so...
Have I ever fired a gun?
No.
Oh, that's
so
a problem.
So how am I supposed to duel one of the most accomplished outlaws in the West?
Because you are in the body of...
I am in the body of an old man. Long past his prime days as a gunslinger.
Oh, the fistful of dollars scenario.
Can
Clint
we just
Eastwood.
Try
the shield.
To shoot the cans?
Tell me about our first date.
Oh, okay.
We've been friends for a few years. Work friends. We'd always been seeing other people. I mean, nothing serious, but... I don't know, it just never lined up. And then... one day, we were both kind of single. And, you asked me out. Something was suddenly different. The way you looked at me. We shut that place down and then went back to yours and... I
shut it down.
We've been kind of inseparable ever since. Here we go. Whoa, okay.
What?
That's a good start. Can I help?
Please.
Well, this is going to be awkward.
No. To your eye.
How's this?
It's good. Ready?
They both feel the heat.
Not that bad.
Not that bad.
Yes.
Well, it looks like it's been a while since you had a gun in your hand.
Oh, they need me back in HQ. I'll be right back.
I'm Henry, the one deputy that didn't take McDonough's bribe. Mayor?
He's taking a stand, I guess. Ooh, oh, he's good. Teach me, Obi-Wan.
This isn't a formal inquiry, just a friendly check-in. Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Well, she's not sitting.
Well, this is a thrilling experience for you. First woman selected to travel through time, working side by side with your fiancé. How are things going around here?
She's Testing not saying well?
Yes,
a lot.
Excited by the progress? Yes, ma'am. You don't have to just answer with yes, ma'am. Permission to speak freely and add any color you think might be helpful. Yes, ma'am. Is there anything going on here that I should know about? No, ma'am. Not, I guess.
Say as little as possible.
Well, thank you, Captain. Great seeing you. This has been deeply illuminating. Yes, ma'am.
Almost.
Okay. That's okay. You're still a little rusty, all right? Ain't nothing you can't work out with some practice. The way I was born, I spent most of my life letting folks see me as someone I wasn't. Till one day I decided I didn't want to do that no more. I wanted to be seen for who I really am. This town really was my salvation, and I will defend it until my very last breath.
It's his home.
Then I better give this one more shot.
Because it could be your last. Hopefully not. Oh!
I hate guns!
Ho, ho, ho!
Let me see that. You got a doctor in this town?
That was just... Depends. That was just unlucky for him. For Ben.
God, it stings. What is that?
Ancient Chinese secret.
Calgon?
Kidding, it's just aloe.
Oh, aloe. Okay.
Felsay.
Do you speak Cantonese?
I guess so.
He does. Hear ya.
My father lost his hearing doing demolition for the railroad.
Hmm.
Ever since we came to Salvation, all he's wanted to do is open his own restaurant. Valentina is like family to all of us. The people in this town would follow her into hell if she
has. Oh, that didn't look sound good. Ah, set it on fire.
1 second, I'm in there fixing a wagon wheel. The next, a stick of dynamite comes flying in. Boom.
McDonough.
This shop's all I had in the world. Now, what am I gonna do? I got nowhere else to go.
I mean, that's what we do in Salvation. We stick together.
Some of us, anyway. Looks like McDonough's plan worked. He's scaring people off.
No, he's not gonna scare us. This fight isn't over. Right, Abuelo?
I know you all want me to fight, but I think there might be a better way.
What is it?
Just give it a little time.
We don't have much time left.
You're a coward.
Valentino.
Baba said you were a washed up, wasted drunk. I hoped you were more, but he was right. You mean nothing to me.
Oh, that's not good.
I guess you're wondering how a former cyber criminal goes from hacking Bitcoin accounts on the dark web to being chief of security of a top secret $1 billion government sanctioned time travel project.
Oh, I'm aware of how Admiral Williams lobbied for your release from prison.
Magic knew what I could bring to the table. As chief of security, you are duty bound to report per the terms of your release.
Bearing that in mind, have there been any incidents in recent weeks you'd care to share now?
I'd actually need written authorization from the Pentagon to be able to discuss the program with anybody who does not have day-to-day clearance.
Nice.
Do you have it in writing?
No. Oh.
I'm a former felon. I learned my lesson.
Get it in writing. Now.
I think that about does it.
Be gone, woman.
Drinking straight from the bottle. It's not a very Ben song move.
Let's say I can put aside all morality and agree to kill this man for the sake of the town. I can't physically do it. I'm not in the body of a prize fighter. I'm an old man who can't shoot straight.
Where are you going?
If I can't save Salvation, maybe I can try to save her.
Who's this dude? Why is he giving the stink eye?
Ben.
Oh,
she
no.
She got the guns.
She got the guns.
Okay, you don't think she...
Oh, no. Henry, have you seen Valentina?
Not since the fire. Why?
She took my guns. I think she went after McDonough.
She did.
Oh, no.
Easy.
Girl's got gumption. I'll give her that. Anyone fool enough to come up on me and try to take a shot? I don't care what your age. That's something I ain't likely to forgive. I see the way this town looks at you. They've invested the little hope they have into a legendary gunfighter. Savior of Salvation. I gun you down.
Up, showdown.
All that hope evaporates away. And they'll abandon this town without me having to fire another shot. You lose. You die. But she lives.
Tomorrow then. High noon.
High noon.
I'm guessing you're gonna want these.
I'm still going with the fistful of dollars shield scenario underneath the poncho.
Diego has agreed to duel Josiah McDonough for the town.
Ming's a chemist. His dad is basically an explosives expert.
Oh.
Frankie has 1,000 gallons of 100-proof whiskey.
Use their skills to their advantage. In a three amigos sort of way.
If we can capture McDonough and his posse alive, we might... Listen, if we can capture them alive, we collect $10,000, which is more than enough money to pay off the railroad and buy us some peace, right? This place means more to us than it does to him.
Ben rallying the troops.
I have a plan, but it's going to take all of us. If we want that money, we can't kill any of them.
What are you thinking?
All right, Hannibal.
I understand.
Get your A-team together.
Firewall.
It doesn't matter if it's a run-of-the-mill bug in the system or if it's a targeted cyber attack. We treat each and every glitch as if it were a DDoS. A distributed denial of service, basically.
Almost feels like you're trying to be intentionally opaque.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, that's just how I talk.
So, I just ran into Ian, who just finished with Congresswoman Adani.
How'd it go?
Not great. I think I have something we can use in our defense.
Oh,
what is it?
Information I'm sure she doesn't want you or anyone else to see.
Where'd you get this?
Dirt on the Congresswoman.
If this got out, it could destroy her career.
It's why I'm giving it to you. In case you find yourself in need of a nuclear option. How far are you willing to go to save Quantum Leap?
That's a good question. How far is Magic willing to go?
Looks like your old boiler done chickened out, little lady.
Oh, I guess not.
Looks can be deceiving.
Should've left when you had the chance.
Turn yourself in. Let us take you. Peaceful-like.
Nah. How about we get our duel out of the way?
Change of plans. Now, Henry!
Woohoo! Nice shot! Miss Kitty. Ring of fire. All right.
That's for burning my shop.
Think twice about that if I were you. I won't shoot you, but the new sheriff might.
He's been promoted.
Maybe we can work something out here.
Too late. Telegraph went out this morning, and these here fine folks are the marshals will be here to haul you and your boys in come sunup. Should have left while you had the chance, huh? Amigo.
I genuinely do believe in Project Quantum Leap, and I tried to give you a chance to come clean, but I'm afraid it's too late for that. Now that I know that the program has been compromised, you leave me no choice but to pass this up to chain of command.
You can't let them shut us down. Not until we bring Ben back.
That is for the committee to decide.
Time to go nuclear, Magic.
10 years ago.
There you go.
You and your brother took a joyride after a night of drinking.
Oh, no.
That was an accident. Your brother was killed. He was behind the wheel.
Oh.
But he wasn't. Was he, Congresswoman?
Are you blackmailing
she
me?
She was. Ooh. No.
That is
nuclear.
Then why are you bringing this up?
Quantum Leap technology works. What if Ben could jump back 10 years and make sure you two never get into that.
That's not how it works.
We can save your brother. We just need time to figure out how. But if you shut us down, I can't help you.
It's only for her benefit, I guess.
What'll it be?
Please tell me she's not going to shut us down, leaving Ben stranded.
No. Not yet.
So you use a nuclear option?
Not exactly. I told her we could go back and save her brother's life.
Magic, we can't do that. I mean, yeah. The technology, it doesn't support us leaping to a specific moment in time.
I know that. Bought us time.
Yeah.
Bought you time.
Bottom time.
Use it. Figure out how to get Ben back here.
A toast to mi abuelo, Diego de la Cruz, the savior of salvation.
She shouldn't be drinking. She's 15.
Apparently, there's a copper deposit a few miles due west of here. Might come in real handy with that new invention, the telephone.
Oh, that's a good one.
So, happen to know there's a pretty good copper vein a couple miles west. Folks might want to stake that claim before the telephone companies do.
I think those newfangled talk boxes are going to be a thing.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Phones.
Look, it's kind of like our first date. Is it possible to kiss a hologram? Because I really want to right now.
Oh.
She made a serious miscalculation calling her Ben.
Did he just call you Ben?
How did you know my name?
I know everything about you, Dr. Ben Song, from the year 2022. But if you value your life, you need to stop following me.
Oh.
Do you understand?
Sam? All right. All right. Episode number 5 of Quantum Leap, Salvation or Bust. There weren't really any major Easter eggs, although Addison was hitting her device at Earth that provides information for Ben, and she was hitting it in a way that Al did back in the OG series when he tried to get information from Ziggy. and which was somewhat a nod to the old series. So that was cool. But other than that, the only major big bombshell was at the end of the episode where that individual who gave the stink eye to Ben as he was sitting at the table drinking and talking to Addison actually knew him by name. And apparently, and that stranger said that, stop following me. So there's so many things going on in my head right now that I'm thinking that it could be Sam, but I don't think it is. It could be the Evil Leaper. It's those two scenarios that are in my head right now, because the Evil Leaper is quite possibly still out there, just doing wrong instead of right, making things harder or difficult, or instead of fixing things to make things better, the opposite of what Sam was doing. So, yeah, yeah, it's going to be interesting, to say the least, who that individual was, if it is Sam or somebody else that that leapt way back when. Or it could be that, it could be anything really. So and there's a possibly another scenario. It could be Al, who knows. His consciousness is possibly leaped as well. Who knows at this point? But I'm just sticking to those three scenarios. Sam, the Evil Leaper, and the stretch that I'm possibly going with is Al's consciousness. That was leaping, trying to find Sam. So probably that's what Janice was working on with his father. So that's a possibility right there. And during this episode, we find out that that Ben is a pacifist, and I was actually thinking that if it was going like I mentioned in the during my reaction, that if it does come down to a showdown, it'll all come down to like a fistful of dollars Clint Eastwood a scenario where the main villain shoots him, but there's like a shield, metal shield underneath his poncho, but that didn't happen. So Ben used his smarts and the skills of the townspeople instead of using guns. So brains than brawn, in other words. But all in all, it was a good episode. And congresswoman tried to put a wrench in the whole thing by trying to shut down the project, Quantum Leap. But thanks to Jen and the dirt that she gave to Magic to go nuclear, that basically was the, that it shut down any plans for shutdown. So yeah, but it's going to complicate things more. I don't know how, but with how Magic was able to convince the congresswoman to keep the project going, and just telling her that Ben's gonna try to leap in order to save that situation she was in that caused her brother to die. So, and that's not how it goes. It's like, that's not how the Force works, in Star Wars speak. But in any case, I hope you enjoyed my reaction. Looking forward to the episode 6. I believe from one of the promos I saw online. I didn't watch the episode, this episode, just to keep my to be surprised at what I saw. But I saw the promos of next week's online, and I believe he's going to San Francisco during the earthquake. So that's gonna be interesting, to say the least. How he's gonna navigate that. In any case, If you enjoyed any of my content, whether it be from my Inner Sanctum channel or YG Anime channel for all things anime, link is right there. Check that out. Help support that channel. Thank you for supporting this channel. Tip of the hat to you. And like I said, if you enjoyed either content for your channel, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe, hit the notification bell in order to be notified of any future videos being posted on your channel. When it comes to the full-length reactions of this episode, you posted it on Patreon and Rumble, along with my other past videos that are posted. All full length, like I said, sync up on your end. Those two links, along with my social media links, posted under this video in the description section. And with that said, tip my hat to you, may the force be with you. Until next time, for us Quantum Leap fans, whatever we're called, our fandom, for the next episode of Quantum Leap. All right? Later.